Namaste children, I am Smita, your English teacher from Mangala Vidya Mandira. Class 6 Standard, Subject English.
In today's class, let us learn a poem called as My People. So, poem 6, My People. So, this poem was written by Siddhalingaya Devaya. He was born in the year 1954 in Magadi, Bangalore. He is an Indian poet, playwright who writes in Kannada language. He is also a Dalit activist and politician. He is credited with starting the Dalit Bandaya movement in Kannada and with starting the genre of Dalit writing. He is one of the founders of the Dalita Sangharsha Samiti along with B. Krishnappa. This poem was translated to English by Sumatendra Nadi, who was a well-known writer. In today's class, let us learn a poem called as My People. So, Unit 7 poem, My People. Children, Dalits were highly discriminated in the society before independence. But Dr. B.R. Ambedkar had played a significant role in minimizing the caste discrimination that was prevalent in the society. So, in this poem, My People, the poet emphasizes the fact that though the Dalits in the society do the same work as done by other caste people, they are oppressed or ill-treated by others. The miseries of these people are highlighted in the poem, My People. Now, during early days, they were even denied of basic education and they did not enjoy the basic amenities that were enjoyed by the other caste people. So, let us learn a new poem called as My People. They carry stones for building sites. They get kicked until they swoon. They die from hunger, My People. The poet says that these people work hard. They carry stones to construct buildings. Their hard labor is never recognized. Instead, they are kicked hard, ill-treated until they swoon. Swoon means faint and die due to hunger. They excavate gold, but they don't get a meal. They weave cloth, but they go naked, My People. Okay, so he says that his people, that is the Dalits, they excavate, means dig gold, but they do not get even a single meal a day. They weave the cloth, but they themselves do not have a good cloth to wear. They plow the field and they sow the seeds, they cut the crops and they are baked in the sun, My People. They plow the fields, sow the seeds, grow the crops and cut the crops, put a lot of effort in providing food to the people, but they themselves are baked. Baked means they dry out in the sun, bear the intense heat of the sun and do not get to enjoy the fruit of their hard work, according to the poet. They come home empty-handed. They heave a deep, deep sigh. They live in misery, My People. They do not get enough money for their hard work. And they come home empty-handed. They leave out a deep sigh or leave a deep breath. They also live in misery. Misery means state of great physical or mental distress. They build the shops and they raise the bungalows. They get into heavy debts, My People. So these people also build the shops and the bungalows. But these are the people who do not have money to pay back the taken amount and therefore fall into heavy debts. Debts means something that is due, that should be paid to others. When they collapse on the street, they don't cry for help. They suppress their cries, My People. So the poet says that these people are those, that is Dalits are those who do not cry when they collapse. Collapse means suddenly fall down on the road and they try to suppress. Suppress means control their sadness by not expressing it. They pay interest through their noses. They become ash in the fire of fiery speeches, My People. These people pay interest through the noses. So, Dalits pay interest through the noses. That means they pay an excess amount or interest for the debts taken. These people completely become ashes due to the speeches of the oppressors. That means they are always subjected to insults by the other caste people. For the God-loving men who eat their fill, they prepare footwear, my people. So the poet says that these people even make footwears for those people who are religious, but Dalits are not even allowed to take part in various religious events. They fall at others' feet and they get kicked. They are so devoted, my people. Though they are devoted in doing their tasks all throughout their life, these people are often kicked by others when they fall at others' feet. Their efforts always go waste and people do not respect or show concern towards them. Their experiences are completely away from those experienced by people of other castes, according to the poet. They listen to anything said to them. They live on air, my people. So poet says that his people are ready to listen and obey to whatever is asked to do by others. When his people do so many things for others, what they get in return is nothing, according to the poet. So this disturbs the poet a lot. So he pleads the society to give equal rights and opportunities to them like others and stop showing cruelty to these people. I hope you have understood this poem, children. So caste discrimination has to be removed from the society. God has created everybody equally. That has to be remembered by all of us, isn't it? So we should not discriminate someone on the basis of the caste, which is created by ourselves, that is created by the human society. And let us treat everyone as our brothers and sisters. Children, now coming to the homework part. You have to write a paragraph on the writer Sumatendra R. Nadig and send it through WhatsApp. Thank you, children.